turbulence surrounding you. These trying times that are so hard to endure. In the middle of what seems to be your darkest hour, hold fast your heart and be assured. This trial shall pass like every night that's come before. He'll never give you more than you can bear.
taking single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Never one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some hell-bent heart leave you bitter. If you come close to sun out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing. When you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance.
Time is a wheel in constant motion, always rolling us along.
I hope
tell
you dance.
Once you look back on the years and wonder
never one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some hell-bent heart leave you bitter. If you come close to sun out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing vent. When you get the choice to sit it out or dance, whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance. I hope you dance.
afternoon, everyone, and welcome to a tribute and celebration of a beautiful and talented artist, Miss Rosa Rosita Baltazar. I'd like to take this opportunity to extend our heartfelt sympathies to the Baltazar family. I bring you sympathies from the Minister Manuel Heredia, Minister of the National, Minister of Tourism, Culture, and Civil Aviation, as well as President of NICH, Ms. Diane Haylock, who could not be here because she's currently out of the country. So I extend their sympathies to you. A tribute to Ms. Rosa Rosita Baltazar. She graced both local and international stages, from Central to North America, from the Caribbean to Europe. Ms. Rosita performed with that signature exuberance and radiant smile, and reflected the passion for dance that lit her from within. She was Belize's ballerina, with her love of classical dance, but she also shined in folkloric dance. Gamboling across the stage as she portrayed the two-foot call and numerous other vibrant displays of cultural dance. Today, others will eulogize her as a beloved relative, friend, or fellow dancer. At the National Institute of Culture and History, we also lovingly remember her in this personal manner. But we also treasure her as the humble national dance icon she was and she will always be. Like a rose that unfurled from a small bud to bloom, so was Miss Rosita when she danced. Her love of dance began at a young age growing up in the cultural melting pot of Punta Gorda town, and it was firmly established during her years dancing with Leomar School of Dance, as well as with the Belize National Dance Company, where she flourished as one of the founding members. Many will recall her role in the production of Budbank Wedding, and Rosita, who also represented us at many different festivals, including Carifesta. Indeed, many are her accolades today. It spans her artistic career. But for us at NICH and the Institute of Creative Arts, we must today express our gratitude and admiration for Ms. Rosita's contribution to dance education in Belize. Molding the arts in excellence. This is the motto for the Institute of Creative Arts. And Ms. Rosita put this into good practice. Touching the lives of hundreds of children over the years, inspiring them to excellence in dance. Year after year, choreographies came to the Bliss stage as golden entries in the National Festival of Arts through the various schools that Ms. Rosita worked with as a dance instructor. As the artistic director of the Junior National Dance Company, Ms. Rosita spent countless hours guiding, teaching, always speaking tenderly with affection to her little dancers. She was also instrumental in the growth and development of the San Pedro Dance Company. Her role of dance educator extended internationally through her association with the Garfuna Heritage Foundation at St. Vincent, aiding in the small island nation with choreography and the Garfuna culture revival. The Ministry of Culture, Tourism, and Civil Aviation, through the National Institute of Culture and History, remains committed to maintaining the passion and dedication for the arts that was the hallmark of Miss Rosita's life. Her legacy will never fade. Rest in peace and dance in glory, Miss Ross. We now call on Miss Jael August to do a special item.
This one's for you, Miss Ross.
Thank you, Jael. We will now have a presentation from the neo-catechumenal community, which Ms. Ross was a part of.
Good afternoon. Thanks for being here in support of a very wonderful and spiritual person, Rosita. Rosita is one of those exceptional persons who will never be forgotten because she always makes a positive impression on people. Yes, she will be missed. Rosita had two passions, her love for God and for her work as a professional dancer and teacher. I first met Rosita 3 years ago when she joined the neo-catechumenal community in Ladyville and became a devoted member. On our weekend session, by listening to scripture reading, then member gave an echo on them and how they felt about God's word. Rosita always captured everyone's attention of how God's message mean to her, and we were amazed of how she felt about the truth of God's love. She truly helped us to understand God, God's grace and humanity. Rosita taught us how much we need to have God's faith, be humble, and become good Christians and love one another. Rosita, our sister in Christ, will remain in us, and she will be remembered for her amazing ways of seeing God's presence in our daily life and keep nourishing of the Word of God. The rose is a beautiful flower, and so Rosita, with her splendid smile, happiness, humbleness, and confidence on our God, our Creator. This message is clear. We have get to know Rosita over 3 years, and she was very spiritual. She loved God and she loved people, especially children. So I ask you to give her the praise that she has earned on earth. Thanks.
We will now have a beautiful presentation by the Garifuna Choir.
La 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 la. Lord, I am weary of this life. I am living in a world full of strife. My life is not what it should be. Speak to me, Lord, and help me. Speak to me, Lord, help me. Help me accept the things I cannot change. Speak to me, Lord, help me. Help me accept what I cannot change. Lord, this is a weary, weary world. Sometimes I wonder why I am living. But then I think this is how it must be. Must it, Lord? Speak and answer me. Yes. Speak to me, Lord, help me. Help me accept the things I cannot change. Help me accept what I cannot change. Teach me to live just as you choose. How to accept and not to refuse. Help me, oh Lord. I beg you, don't let me be. Speak to me, Lord, and answer me. Speak to me, Lord, help me. Help me accept the things I cannot change. Help me accept what I cannot change. Oh Lord, help me accept what I cannot change. Please help me, oh Lord. Help me accept what I cannot change.
We will now hear some words from a member of Christ Renews His Parish.
Good afternoon, everyone. A tribute to Rosita from CHIRP, Christ Renews His Parish Retreat for Women. Rosita served for 2 years, 2013 and 2014, on the Holy Redeemer Christ Renews His Parish Retreat Team. Our beloved sister in Christ, Rosa, was a delightful breath of fresh air when she was around us, always smiling and willing to give her all and her best to Jesus and to us. As exuberant as her dancing was her radiant zeal for loving and serving her Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. Her living testimony will continue to flourish in the hearts of all of us who have been blessed by the presence of this dynamic, godly woman who dwelled among us. Ross is now with her Jesus, her greatest and most faithful friend and lover, dancing and safe forever in his arms. Have a dance for us, Russ. We love you and miss you and look forward to seeing you someday and dancing. Psalm 150 verse 4 says, give praise with tambourines and dance. Praise him with flutes and strings. I thank you on behalf of the Holy Redeemer Christ Renews His Parish Retreat Team.
We will now have a musical item from Mr. Whitfield Welch, Why Me, Lord?
Why me, Lord, what have I ever done to deserve even one of the pleasures I've known? Tell me, Lord, what did I ever do that was worth loving you? Or the kindness you shown. Lord, help me, Jesus. I've waited. It's so, help me, Jesus. I know what I am. And now that I know that I needed you so, help me, Jesus. My soul's in your hands. Try me, Lord, if you think there's a way I can try to repay all I've taken from you. Maybe, Lord, I can show someone else what I've been through myself on my way back to you. And Lord, me Jesus, I've wasted it, so help me Jesus, I know what I am. And now that I know that I needed you, so help me Jesus, my soul's in your hands. Oh Jesus, my soul's in your hands. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Welch, a man of many talents. You didn't tell me you could sing. We will now have a dance presentation by the San Pedro Dance Company.
Good afternoon. First, I would like to introduce myself. I am Lily Nunez, founder of San Pedro Dance Company. 16 years ago, when the San Pedro Dance Company was formed, we invited Rosita to join our dance company as the dance choreographer. I never thought that she would be with us for so long, but I am glad she did, because for us, she was the best. She was young, energetic, and always willing to go the extra miles. She was ready to take any challenges put by the company. Our dance company, under her directions, became a strong dance group, and some of our dancers had the privilege to join our sister company, the Belize Dance Company, in their European dance tour. Rosita soon became one of us. She loved the island and its people. Our dance company became hers. Her students remember her as being strict, loving, and helpful. She wanted all her dancers to become strong dancers, so she dedicated her time unselfishly to mold them into becoming one. The people of San Pedro will always remember the glamorous shows she presented for the annual International Costa Maya Festival and the Christmas pageants with all the spirit of the season. Her shows were grand and to be envied. Through her dancing and as a disciplinaire, Rosita changed the life of many of the island kids. She made them believe in themselves. Rosita will live in our hearts forever. Rosita is part of the history of San Pedro. She is el orgullo sanpedrano. Rosita was no longer just my friend, she became my sister. And I cherish every moment we spent together. I am thankful for her contribution to the San Pedro Dance Company and the San Pedro. On behalf of the San Pedro community, I sincerely express my sympathies to the family of Rosita Baltazar. Rosita, hermana, rest in peace. I brought your dancers for you to see them dance right in front of you. But before our dance, Miss Irma, president of our company, will give a little something from the dance company to the sisters and Rosita's son.
Thank you.
Now, I introduce to you our San Pedro, some of our San Pedro dancers. Rosita, here you have it, sister.
Thank you very much, San Pedro Dance Company. We will now have another music item being sung by Miss Rajani Perriott, Candle in the Wind.
Will always follow you among Belize's greenest hills.
which we'll always carry for our nation's golden child. And even though we try, the truth brings us to tears. All our words cannot express the joy you brought us through the years. And it seemed to me your dance steps will always follow along Belize's greenest hills. The candles burned out long before your legend never
We will now have a presentation from the Belize National Dance Company. We will now have some remarks from Ms. Sisti.
Good afternoon. All of us in here know how wonderful Rosita was. I am going to say a little poem with words which I think Rosita would like me to say to you. She says, I have only slipped away to the next room. I am I. You are you. Whatever we were to each other, that we still are. Call me by my old familiar name. Speak of me, speak to me in the easy way which you always used. Put no difference into your tone. Wear no forced air of solemnity or sorrow. Laugh as we always laughed at the little jokes we enjoyed together. Play, smile, think of me, pray for me. Let my name be ever the household word that it always was. Let it be spoken without effect, without the trace of a shadow on it. Life means all that it ever meant. It is the same as it ever was. There is absolute, unbroken continuity. Why should I be out of mind because I am out of sight? I am but waiting for you, for an interval, somewhere, very near, just around the corner. All is well. Nothing is past. Nothing is lost. One brief moment, and all will be as it was before, only better, infinitely happier. And forever, we will be one together with Christ. See you, Rosa.
We now call on the Castillo family to make some remarks, after which we will be doing a video tribute, and we will be moving over into the celebration mass.
Good evening, everyone. Rosita started working for my mother, Mrs. Addy Castillo, in the early 80s. She was very young and was with us for 12 years as our housekeeper. She was very young and naive like me, so we both learned a lot from each other, with my mom being our mentor. She also brought with her cooking experience she had learned from working prior with Miss Rita Waite, my mother's comadre, who had a restaurant at the time. Her lobster thermidors and potatoes in jacket were my favorite, all so yummy. We were so sad when she gave notice she was leaving us, but we knew she wanted to pursue her passion for dancing. And my mother assisted her to go to Sarasota for her workshop. And then the rest is history. She became a shining star in Belize and internationally. So many words can describe Rose, as I affectionately called her. She was bubbly, kind, courteous, respectful, spiritual, open-minded, affectionate, energetic, and so much fun. So eager to learn and very proud of her Garifuna culture. But what we can most recall was her infectious smile and her passion for dancing. Her face and body would just light up like a Christmas tree. A few times when my mom was away, I would have my close friends come over and I would say to Rose, Gyal, my friend and I come over and all away want you teach me how to punta. Of course, I had already been practicing and with her from prior, so I was always ready for the punta party. Then we would all jump up on my mother's coffee table and punta, punta, punta. My mom did find out, though, later on. Was not too happy about it, and we both got our good scolding. But we didn't mind, because we already had a great time. We will always love her dearly and remember the good times. We are so proud of her accomplishments and always followed her career on social media. And we're very saddened when we learned of her cancer in 2012, but we always prayed for positive results. She and I often chatted on Facebook. Belize has truly lost an amazing patriot who made this jewel of ours a better place. Our deepest sympathies to her family, close friends, and students. Beautiful, graceful Rose, gone way too soon, but you certainly left your passion for dancing with so many who love you. Go with the angels above and keep on smiling and dancing. We will never forget you, querida amiga. Thank you.
We now ask you to rise as we sing our entrance hymn.
And the God of all consolation. He comforts us all in our affliction, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bless the body of Rosita with the holy water of which St. Paul writes, all of us who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his resurrection, on the day of her baptism, Rosita put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed in glory.
She was lost in so many different ways, out in the darkness with no guide. I know the cost of a losing hand there, but for the grace of God, oh, I found heaven on earth. You are my last, my first, and then I hear this voice inside. Thank you.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us bow our heads in prayer. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of the saints, give, we pray, your servant, Rosita, for whom we perform the fraternal office of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of the resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, she may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated for our scripture readings.
Praise the Lord. The first reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom. The soul of the just are in the hand of the Lord, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise the little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as a sacrificial offering, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. Praise be to God.
The response for the responsorial psalm is Anihe Baba Wama Fregi Wama Lu Wabungute Idera Lamuga Lida Gesiante Anihe Baba Wama Fregi Wama Lu Wabungute Dusumalamuga Wacharaya Ubo Wogo. Anihe Baba Wama Fregi Wama Lu Wabungute Idera Bawa Lida Gesiante Fredi Bawa Wagu Wabungute Selu rugabu grasu wa wagu berahi wagia damela siru adune haba wa lida femeri. Thank you. Weri halifigo ya uba wogu Chulu hata lu barufu duni Bubafu wole le maguma shugu ati Wamalu wapungi ute Idara la muga walidage Egi wamalu wabugize Dusu malamu ga wachara ya ubogo
Second reading. To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to gain and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to sew. A time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
Let us all now rise for the gospel acclamation. Agamba wame. Agamba wame, gamba wame.
Thank you. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, escorted by all the angels of heaven, he will sit upon his royal throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. Then he will separate them in two groups, as a shepherd separates sheep from goats. The sheep he will place on his right, the goats on his left. The king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who have my Father's blessing, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the creation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me, naked and you clothed me. I was ill and you comforted me, in prison and you came to visit me.' Then the just will ask him, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you? Or see you thirsty and give you drink? When did we welcome you away from home or clothe you in your nakedness? When did we visit you when you were ill or in prison?' The king will answer them, 'I assure you, as often as you did it for one of my least brothers, you did it for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Out of my sight, you condemned, into the everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels. I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. I was away from home, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. I was ill and in prison, and you did not come to comfort me.' Then they in turn will ask, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or away from home or naked or ill or in prison and not attend you in your needs?' He will answer them, I assure you, as often as you neglected to do it to one of these least ones, you neglected to do it to me. These will go off to eternal punishment, and the just to eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord.
Before I start my homily, I want to say that the rector of the cathedral, Father Larry, who is on vacation, sends his sympathy and his support and prayers to Rosita's family. He's sorry he cannot be here, but I'm very happy to be a part of this celebration of her homecoming to Almighty God. As I was thinking and preparing my homily for the late Miss Rosita Baltasar, the song written by Sidney Carter came to mind. He wrote the song over 50 years ago. We sung the song during my seminary days in the seminary, and we sung the song at Mass there also, both in Belize and in the U.S., and we still sing the song. The title of the song is "Lord of the Dance." I can see and I can picture the late Rosita dancing around the banquet table of Almighty God. We are gathered here this afternoon to celebrate the life and legacy of the late Rosita Baltasar, who has touched the hearts and minds of so many people nationally and internationally. I feel that it is a privilege and an honor to be asked, to have been asked to celebrate the Mass of Resurrection and Homecoming. I can remember her being an active member of Our Lady of the Way Catholic Church in Ladyville when I was pastor there. She attended the 7 o'clock Saturday evening or Saturday night Mass most of the time. She always had a smile on her face and a kind word to offer. She always thanked and praised God for the many blessings he has given her. I agree with sacred scripture where it says, there is a time for every season. There is a time for everything under heaven. The preacher of Ecclesiastes says in one of his lines, there is a time to mourn and there is a time to dance. And I knew Rosita, and I know that Rosita was a faithful and active member of the church community. We have heard and we have witnessed many good things about Rosita this afternoon. Her talents, faith, and generosity. We have seen her graciousness, calmness, and her patient ways. We know that she was an exemplary giving person. We know that she had zeal and zest for life and an inner joy that came from Almighty God. All these things are wonderful, but the one thing that has struck in our minds most vividly is that Rosita loved to dance. Rosita was a fabulous dancer, and she danced for God's glory, and she danced for God's honor. Perhaps her dancing moves enable her to get closer to people, to reach out and touch people, how to care for people, and how to attract and nurture children, and be close to her God and to her Garifuna community. We know that she is doing spiritual dancing with our Heavenly Father. She knew how to dance the spiritual ballet gracefully, carefully, and respectfully. She knew how to dance the spiritual ballet precise, delicate, and a delight to behold. The gift of her grace under pressure tells us that here is a lady who knew who she was, who was in command of her own soul, and who understand that she could shape how others felt just by her deep serenity in her own heart. Oh, praise Almighty God and thank Almighty God for Rosita dancing spiritually and by calming others with her deep calmness. There is a time for dancing. I am not sure I have answered the issue I began with. For everything, there is a season, a time for everything under the heaven, a time to mourn and a time to dance. Is this the time to mourn or the time to dance? Rosita, that fabulous spiritual dancer, the ability to get close to people, she had the spiritual essence of remaining calm and patient, disciplined and careful. Rosita found plain joy in giving, who did not permit herself the luxury of being depressed, but who simply each day went about with anticipation for that day and with eagerness for all it might bring. I envision Rosita as giving ample testimony to the wonder of life and the joy of living it. Rosita professed Christ at a very young age, and she knew and loved the Lord. She leaves a legacy of faith, strong faith. We can see and hear her dance, all of that. We see a woman whose family was such a source of joy. As a young woman, she helped and cared for her siblings, and all of them have remained close. We know that she made and kept friends well. Rosita was a fabulous dancer, and now we return to Ecclesiastes. Is this a time to mourn or a time to dance? What time is it? A time to mourn or a time to dance? Brothers and sisters, we may grieve for a while, but thanks be to God, we have something to dance about. There is a time to mourn, and doubtlessly you have been doing that. But there is also a time to dance. Weeping is for a night, but joy comes in the morning. For the Lord Jesus Christ is a foretaste of divine glory. He took on death so that we would not have to die. He took on death and defeated it, so that whoever lives and believes in him will never, ever die. Do not stay in grief for your sister Rosita, for God so loved Rosita that he gave his only begotten son, so that when Rosita trusted him, Rosita received everlasting life. This is not a time to mourn. This is a time to dance. Oh, it may have been a time to mourn, but now it is a time to dance. It may have been a time to grieve, but now it is a time for leaping and shouting and dancing, a time for joy. Joy is coming in this glad morning. And Rosita, weep not for her. Rosita is dancing. Rosita is dancing all over God's heaven. The Lord God has given life, and the Lord God has taken life away. And blessed be the name of Almighty God.
May we stand up and we gather at the altar of the Lord to offer our prayers, our petitions, our needs, and our desires, and place them before the throne of grace.
For the Holy Catholic Church, for Francis our Pope, Derek our Bishop, and for all bishops, priests, deacons, and laymen and women, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the leaders of Belize, that they would promote life, peace, and justice, and work together for the common good, we pray to the Lord. Lord,
we pray for families who are suffering spiritually, physically, and those in sorrow, especially the family and friends of the Baltasar family. May God bless them with strength and courage in their time of bereavement. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we turn to you. We ask you that those who are sick
our loved ones, those that are at home in bed, for those in the hospital, dear Lord, embrace them and give them your healing power, because only you know what is best for them. For this, we pray to the Lord. For those who have departed from here, who are in with you, dear Lord, we pray, dear Lord, that as you embrace them and welcome them into your embrace, may they find eternal happiness. For this, we pray to the Lord.
And let us bow our heads in prayer. May the prayers of those who cry out to you this afternoon benefit the souls of your servant, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins, and make them sharers in your redemption. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Please join in singing our collection hymn, Arihanali Jesus.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and my sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for as one alone he accepted death so that we might all escape from dying. As one person he chose to die so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in the company of the choirs of angels, saints, and martyrs, we praise you as with joyful celebration we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, Jesus gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Doric Wright, Christopher Glancy, and Osmond Peter Martin, our bishops, and all the ministers of your gospel. Remember Rosita, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, Saint Joseph, Saint Rose, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teachings, we dare to sing.
Wow.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Give thanks with a grateful heart.
with a grateful heart, give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because His giving means a Christ saved son. And now let the weak heart give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because the giving means a Christ saved son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Before the Lord has done for God.
Bread blessed and broken.
Thank you. niece, sister, aunt, colleague, teacher, mentor, advisor, friend. Rosa Baltazar, affectionately known as Rosita, was at least one of those things to everyone here and beyond. Her quiet but firm spirit has touched many lives during her lifetime, and without a doubt, her legacy will live on. Rosita was born to Inez and Mergilda Baltazar in Livingston, Guatemala, on August 1960. She was the sixth of 15 children in a close-knit Baltazar family. She spent her early childhood in Livingston, and her family later moved to Punta Gorda town, where she remained for the rest of her young life. Even though she was a very sickly child growing up, Rosita was also very headstrong, funny, and vivacious. She often got a kick out of teasing and playing practical jokes on her siblings. Little Rosita attended St. Peter Claver Primary School, and it was there that she showcased her natural talent for dance by participating in numerous school plays and variety shows. Tragedy struck the close-knitted family with the passing of Rosita's father. Shortly afterwards, the family moved to Belize City when Rosita was just about 14 years old. She did not attend high school, and up until her mid-teens, she assisted her mother with the family business. These years solidify a mother-daughter bond and birthed life skills and values which defined the woman she became. These values included hard work, dedication, loyalty, humility, faith, independence, determination, and above all, privacy. In her late teens, Rosita entered the job market and started working with the Waite family. Shortly afterwards, she began working with the Castillo family, where she remained for the next 12 years. It was during this time that she gave birth to her only child, Gary Baltazar. These important life changes rekindled Rosita's passion and love for dance. So after work, she began taking dance classes with the Leomar Dance Group. She remained with Leomar Dance Group until her artistic passion led her to the Belize National Dance Company in 1990. At this point, Rosita's life took yet another turn. In 1989, she made the unprecedented decision to leave her, quote, normal job with the Castillo family and became a, quote, full-time dancer. Dance was no longer a passion and a hobby. It became her passion. It became her career, one which focused on performance, dance education, and cultural preservation. Rosita became the assistant artistic director of the newly formed Belize National Dance Company and the artistic director of the Belize National Dance Company Juniors. In those capacities, Rosita played a pivotal role in the early integration of the arts in Belize's national school curriculum. This involved teaching dance in the primary schools throughout Belize and assisting the Ministry of Education with teacher training and developing criteria for the Festival of Arts. Suffice it to say, the next 10 years of Rosita's life was marked by notable accomplishments in dance. She trained with reputable dance schools and legends of Belizean and Caribbean dance. She performed nationally and internationally, representing Belize in dance performances, festivals, exchange programs, and special projects. She even found time to attend evening school and earned her high school diploma in 1998. Throughout her life, Rosita maintained close relationships with her mother, siblings, and relatives. Their bond is rooted in deep cultural identity, fortified by joy, love, and support for each other despite tragedy. In 1997, the passing of Rosita's mother, the matriarch of the Baltazar family, sowed the seed of yet another important element of her life, her spirituality. Most would remember Rosita for her kind, giving spirit. She exudes humility, yet she radiates a calm strength, and she was serious and determined. Her spiritual awakening began with constant prayer, and it later extended to fellowship beyond the passion of dance. Her spiritual journey began with Christ Renews His Parish, which is a spiritual weekend retreat for women designed to help individuals grow in their personal relationship with Jesus Christ and with others in their faith community. Shortly thereafter, Rosita joined the Belize City Garifuna Choir in 2010. She served as singer, choreographer, advisor, mentor, and later spiritual leader. 2 years later, in 2012, she joined the Neo-Catechumenal Way, which is another spiritual community which helps Catholics to delve into the Bible with an emphasis on love for each other and God. As a member, Rosita attended prayer meetings, retreats, and recently earned her first level certificate as a lay minister. Rosita's life was rooted in dance, her family, and her spirituality. Fortified by these elements, she faced the world with unparalleled hope and optimism, punctuated by her unique smile and bright eyes. She did a lot, and for those who know her best, she did it her way. She was diagnosed with breast cancer in 2012. From then until the time of her death, her spirituality was her anchor. Her family were her hope, and dance remained her life. To dance is to live. To live is to dance. Goodbye, Miss Rosita. We know you are dancing with the angels. May your soul rest in peace and dance in glory.
I stand instead of my family, and I want to thank all of Rosita's friends and associates. These are close friends and associates. We thank you all for your support and everything that you did, and you embraced my sister. You know, across cultures, the beautiful cultures of Belize, you embraced her without prejudice, and I thank you so, so much on behalf of my family. You know, when the curtains were closed, there were others who were also there for her. And so we want to say a huge thank you to some close individuals. You know, this is no disrespect to everybody else, all the close friends and associates. We greatly thank you. But this is when the curtains were closed. We want to thank Nurse August. That lady religiously came, rain or shine, to attend to my sister. We thank you, Ma. We want to thank also Miss Irma Skeen and her family, who always ensure that my sister gets to some treatments in time. Thank you, Miss Irma. We also want to thank Mr. Eduardo and Miss Sandra. You embraced my sister. Thank you so, so much. And when I came, because I hadn't been to Belize for quite some time, and they were there, and I greatly, greatly appreciate that. Thank you so much. And we also want to thank close neighbors, Shirlene and Mervyn. Thank you for being there and driving us around, etc., and showing me everything, because the Lord brought me just in time at the last season of my sister's life. And, you know, all these close people, these were neighbors, and they were there, they embraced me, and they helped me along the way until more help came. So thank you all for your tireless love and affection. You all made life bearable, enjoyable, and worth fighting the good fight of faith, the last season of my sister's life. Thank you all. May God bless the work of your hands, and may you increase in favor forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our sister to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and company of the saints. May God give her a merciful judgment and forgive all her sins. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, lead her safely home to be at peace with God our Father, and may she be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Your response will be, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid. Come to meet her angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who calls you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Grant her eternal rest, O Lord, and may light shine forever. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Your response now will be, Lord, save your people. Lord, save your people by your coming as man. By your birth. By your baptism and fasting. By your suffering and cross. By your death and burial,
Lord,
by your rising to new life,
Lord,
by your return in glory to the Father,
Lord,
by your gift of the Holy Spirit,
Lord,
by your coming again in glory.
Lord,
Father, into your hands we commend our sister Rosita. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, she will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave her in this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship with his hours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer and welcome our sister Rosita to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and our sister Rosita forever and ever. Amen.
Commend our sister Rosita to you, Lord. Now that she has passed from this life, may she live on in your presence. In your mercy and love, forgive whatever sins she may have committed through human weakness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And Rosita, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you. Their Lazarus is poor no longer. May you have eternal rest.
I am
the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live, even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death.
Grant her eternal rest, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. And may the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen.
Thank you.
she was lost in so many different ways, out in the darkness with no guide. I know the cost of a losing hand there, but for the grace of God, oh, I found heaven on earth. You are my last, my first, and then I hear this voice inside. Ave Maria.
Yeah.